In the last lecture, we talked about rotation matrices. Now we will expand on that. So now, let's look at rotation of a vector about z-axis. So what does this mean? So let's say we have our x and y-axis and z-axis, and there is a vector r here. Okay, alright. So if you are rotating this vector about z-axis, what it means is that since we are rotating it in the counterclockwise direction, the r vector will be rotated in the counterclockwise direction. Alright. So if r vector is rotated in the counterclockwise, then we can just use the previous formula that we have obtained. So we have a previous formula, which was for rotation of a vector on the xy plane, right? So the formula for this, the rotation matrix for this was just cos theta minus sine theta cos theta. Now this was when we are just rotating it, rotating a vector which is on the xy plane. Now if you are rotating the vector about the z-axis, what it means is that z-axis itself does not change, right? Okay. So the rotation matrix will now be cos theta minus sine theta 0, sine theta cos theta 0 0 0 1. So essentially this is our rotation matrix when we rotate a vector in the xy plane, and then since we are rotating it about the z-axis, so if we are rotating about the z-axis, then obviously the z-axis itself will not change, and the vector which is in the xy plane, that is going to change, or that is going to rotate in the counterclockwise direction. Alright, so this is the matrix. Similarly, if we consider reflection, so there is also something called reflection through the xy plane. After rotation about z-axis. So the rotation matrix for rotating about z-axis was this, right? Cos theta minus sine theta 0, sine theta cos theta 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, this was the rotation matrix for rotating a vector about z-axis. Okay, now what we want to do, we want to reflect it. So basically, if there is an xy plane, alright, so if this was our xy plane and this was our z-axis, this is xy plane and this was our z-axis. Now if you want to reflect it, basically the z component of it will come down, right? So this is called reflection. So now the new matrix after reflection, so reflection through xy plane will create a reflection matrix. Okay. All right. So if this creates a reflection matrix, what this means is that xy plane. So xy plane does not change, and z axis gets reflected. Okay, so the reflection matrix now is cos theta minus sin theta 0, sin theta cos theta 0, and this one will become minus 1. So this is your reflection matrix. Alright, so this is about a particular axis or about a particular plane. Okay, here the axis is about, basically here we have considered about rotation about z axis and then reflection about the xy plane. But in many cases, it's not necessary that we want to do rotation about z axis. We can do rotation about x axis, or we can also do rotation about a particular vector. Right, or about a particular axis which is not just xy but a combination of x and y axis, or combination of x and z axis, or something like that. Right, so we have to now figure out how to do these transformations. But before that, I have a small homework for you. I want you to find out find the three dimensional matrix for rotation about y axis and rotation about x axis. Okay, so this is your homework. All right. So in the last class, okay, we also talked about orthogonal transformation and orthogonal matrices, all right. So the conditions for orthogonal transformations were, so the condition for orthogonal transformation was that if you have some new vector which is defined by a linear combination of the other vectors, for example this, then the length of the new vector should be equal to length of old vector. So what this meant was that x dash square plus y dash square should be equal to x square plus y square. We also talked about orthogonal matrices, right? So orthogonal matrices had the property. So only when you had that M inverse is equal to the transpose of M, you call them the orthogonal matrix. And a property that emerged out of this was that determinant of M is plus or minus 1, right? Or you can also have determinant of M whole square is 1. So this was a property that emerged because the matrices were orthogonal. All right. So now there is a small homework for you. If x dash is equal to ax plus by and y dash is equal to cx plus dy, okay, what are the conditions that make the transformation from xy to x dash y dash orthogonal? Okay, So now you know what an orthogonal transformation is. You also know what an orthogonal matrix is. Also find the matrix M which is orthogonal. Okay, for this transformation. Okay, so this is your homework. All right, now let's look at a certain example where we apply this transformation. Okay, so if you are given, right, if you are given, so the question now is, let's try to find what transformation corresponds to the following. Okay, alright, so you are given a matrix A which is half into minus 1, root 3, minus root 3 and minus 1. So this is your matrix. So this is nothing but minus 1 by 2, root 3 by 2, minus root 3 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. Okay. So if this is your matrix, then the way to find whether it's orthogonal or not, right? We have to find whether it's orthogonal or not. So the first condition is A inverse should be equal to A transpose. If this is the case, then it is A is orthogonal. Okay, so let's find A inverse. So in order to find A inverse, we have to find determinant of A. Okay, so what is the determinant of A? You have half into half, so 1 plus 3, so you have 4 by 4, which is 1. Okay, so this is my determinant. And what is A inverse then? A inverse is just going to be A into C transpose. Okay, so this is determinant of A is 1, so this is just C transpose. So what is C transpose here? So this is nothing but minus 1, root 3, minus root 3 and minus 1. Okay, transpose of that, which will give you minus 1, root 3, minus root 3, minus 1. Okay, so this is your A inverse. And now see, is A inverse equal to A transpose? Let's see. So this is A inverse, and what is A transpose? A transpose is nothing but, so there is a half here, right? So A transpose is nothing but half into minus 1, root 3, minus root 3, minus 1. And this is equal to A inverse. So the matrix is orthogonal. Now let's see what is the, now determinant, what was the determinant that we got was, determinant was 1, alright. So determinant of A is 1, alright. So in an orthogonal matrix you can have determinant either equal to 1 or equal to minus 1. So if the determinant of an orthogonal matrix is 1, then we call it a rotation matrix. Then the transformation is basically a rotation transformation and the matrix is a rotation matrix. But if the determinant of an orthogonal matrix is minus 1, then we call it a reflection transformation or a, and the matrix is a reflection matrix. So in this case, our determinant of A was 1, right? For our example here, determinant of A was 1. So this is a rotation matrix. Now, if this is a rotation matrix, it means that the transformation corresponds to rotation with a certain angle, right? So what was our A? A was minus half, root 3 by 2, minus root 3 by 2, and minus half. So let's consider that rotation was in, because this is a 2 by 2 matrix, so the rotation is in the xy plane. So let's see what this angle corresponds to. So what is this angle? So you can just correspond it to the rotation matrix. So this is cos theta minus sine theta and cos theta. Okay. Alright. So from here you can see that cos theta is nothing but minus half and sine theta is nothing but minus root 3 by 2. Right. You can just correspond it. So this is corresponding to this and this is corresponding to this, right? So you know, you got these values. So now you have to find out the angles. And we know from our quadrant rules that in the first quadrant, all are positive. In the second quadrant, only sine is positive. In the third quadrant, only tan is positive. And in the fourth quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, and this is fourth. In the fourth quadrant, only cos is positive. Okay, so we know this rule. So from here you can see here both cos and sine are negative, which means this lies in the third quadrant. Okay, and we know that when sine theta is root 3 by 2, then theta is 60 degree. And because it lies in the third quadrant, right, because both cos and sine are negative, but then tan will become positive. Tan theta will become positive. So you have theta is nothing but pi plus 60 degree. Okay, so this is our angle. So this is nothing but pi is what, 180. So 180 plus 60, 240 degree. Okay. So the angle that the vector was rotated by was 240 degrees. Alright. Okay. Now we can also calculate, right? Or we can also see what the new vectors will be. So suppose there is a vector. Suppose there is a vector I. Okay. Transformation of vector I. So vector I can be written as 1, 0, right? So there is 0 in the J, for J, and for I there is 1. Okay. So if you now apply this transformation, this matrix, so if you do A dot I, what will you get? Is the question. Okay, so you are going to do half into minus 1 root 3 minus root 3 1 1 0. Okay, so you are going to get, right, so you have to do a matrix multiplication, so you will get minus 1. That's it, and then you will get minus root 3. Okay. So the transformation for A dot I becomes this, right? Which if you write it in vector form, in vector form what this corresponds to is minus half into I plus root 3 J. Okay, this is what it corresponds to. Similarly, we find out for vector j. Okay, transformation of vector j. So what you have to do is you have to find what is a dot j, right? So what is j written as? J can be written as 0 and 1. Okay, so when you transform this, a dot j is nothing but half minus 1 root 3 minus root 3 minus 1 and 0 1. So this will correspond to root 3 and minus 1. Okay, so you will get half into root 3 I minus j. So this is your vector. Okay, all right. Now the next question is, sometimes you want to find what is the rotation axis, okay, what is the axis about which a vector is being rotated, or if it is a reflection matrix, then we want to find what is the plane along which the matrix was reflected, along which the vector was reflected. Okay, so how do we find this, right? So let's look at a problem. Alright. So the question is, find the mappings produced by the following matrices. So we'll look at a reflection matrix and a rotation matrix. Alright. So let's look at the first matrix. So let's say, okay, so G is equal to 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 0. So I am telling you that this is an orthogonal matrix, so you don't have to check that. But what you have to check whether it is a reflection or a rotation matrix. Okay. So reflection or rotation. So how will you check that? The easiest way to check that is to find the determinant of this matrix. So if the determinant is plus 1, then you know that it is a rotation matrix. If the determinant is minus 1, then you know it is a reflection matrix. So the determinant, let's find the determinant. So we'll use this column to calculate the determinant. So it will be minus 1 into minus of 1. So you'll get 1. Okay, so this is a rotation matrix. Alright. So you have found the determinant and you got the determinant value as 1. So this is a rotation matrix. Now, what do I mean by mappings, right? What I mean by mappings is, so if this is the rotation matrix, then what is the angle that this rotation matrix indicates, right? What is the angle through which the vector was rotated and what is the axis through which the vector was rotated, okay? So in order to find, so there are two things we need to find, axis and angle of rotation. Okay, so how do we find axis first? Okay, let's look at how we find axis. So in order to find the axis, we know that if we are rotating about a certain axis, that particular axis or a vector along that axis is not going to change, right? So we can do a transformation where g dot r is equal to r. So what this says is r is a vector along the axis of rotation. Okay, so a vector along the axis of rotation is not going to change because you are rotating about that axis. Okay, so that's why when you apply this g transformation to that r vector, you simply get back the r vector. Okay, there is no change. So let's find out what is the r vector. Okay, so the r vector will be found out using this equation. All right, So what is g? G was our 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 0 into what is our r vector? We can assume that r is something like x I plus y j plus z k. Okay, sorry, z k. So let's assume this is our vector. So you'll have x, y, z, and this will give you back x, y, z. Okay, alright. So let's look at, we have to find the values of x, y, z basically. Alright, so how will we do that? We'll just, because this is a simple matrix, we can just do matrix multiplication and find the values. So this will give us minus z is equal to x, minus y is equal to y, and minus x is equal to z. Now since minus y is equal to y, cannot happen, right? You cannot have minus 1 is equal to 1. So similarly, you cannot have minus y equal to y. So there is no y. So the only possibility is y is equal to 0. And these two are valid. So you have basically x is equal to minus z, or z is equal to minus x. So now you have to find us, you have to construct a simple vector which follow these criteria. So the simplest way would be to assume that z is 1, or to assume that x is 1. Okay, so the simplest vector would be x is 1, therefore z will become minus 1, and y we already know that it is 0. Okay, so the vector r will now be 1, 0, minus 1. Okay, this is our vector. Alright, now this is a vector along the axis, which does not change upon applying rotation matrix, rotation transformation. Okay, alright, so this matrix does not change upon applying rotation transformation. So what is the vector that changes? So a vector which is in a plane perpendicular to this matrix. Okay, so let's imagine that this is our plane. Okay, and there is a so there is some axis of rotation which was perpendicular to this vector. Okay, so this was perpendicular to this plane. Okay, so this is our plane and this is our axis of rotation. And vector r was on this axis of rotation. Okay, so this axis of rotation is basically, so you can say that the vector r itself is the axis of rotation. Alright, so for us the axis of rotation equals r, which we have found it out to be 1, 0, minus 1. So this was our axis of rotation. Now if the plane is perpendicular to this axis of rotation, what we can do is we can have a vector on this plane. Alright. We can have a vector on this plane. Okay. So here maybe we can have a vector which is perpendicular to this axis of rotation. So vector on the plane will be perpendicular to axis of rotation. Alright. So what is the vector on the plane? So let's call the vector on the plane to be xi plus yj plus zk. Okay. And this vector, let's call it u. Okay. This vector is going to be perpendicular to r. Okay, so the condition for perpendicularity is what? U dot r should be 0, right? So we can just multiply u with r. So we have x into 1 plus y into 0, so 0, plus z into minus 1, so minus z equal to 0. So we have x minus z is equal to 0, so we'll get x is equal to z. Okay, so if we have got x is equal to z, this is the condition that the vector on the plane will follow. Okay, so what is u then? U is nothing but so again think of the simplest case. So simplest will be put x equal to 1, so z will also be 1, and there is no y, so you can put it as 0. So 1, 0, 1. So this is your u vector. Okay. Alright. So if you transform this vector, so this is the vector which is being rotated. So this is the vector which is being rotated by a certain angle. Okay. So now we have to find out what is the angle of rotation. Alright. So u, which is 1, 0, 1, is the vector being rotated. So how is it rotated? Using the transformation, right? So what the transformation is, transformation matrix is G, which is 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, and minus 1, 0, 0. So if you apply this transformation G to the vector U, you will get a new vector, right? So this new vector, let's call it V, is nothing but G into U. So what is G into U? Let's do the matrix multiplication. 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 0 into 1, 0, 1. Okay. So this is going to give us a new vector, which is, so this is of order 3 cross 3. This is of order 3 cross 1. So this will give us a vector of order 3 cross 1. Alright. So we will get minus 1, 0, minus 1. Okay. So this is what you will get. Alright. So you had your original vector which was being rotated. Now you have your new vector. This is the vector after rotation. So vector after rotation, which is minus 1, 0, minus 1. Okay. So now you have to find the angle, right? Now because these two vectors are on the same plane, you can just find the angle between them by the formula cos theta is equal to u dot v by norm of u into norm of v. Okay? Alright. So u dot v is nothing but, what is u dot v? U dot v is 1, 0, 1 into, sorry. So u dot v means u into transpose, u transpose v. So this will be nothing but 1, 0, 1 into minus 1, 0, minus 1. So this will give you minus 1, minus 1, which will give you minus 2. Okay? Alright. So this will give you minus 2, and norm of u is 1 square plus 0 square plus 1 square. So this is root 2, and norm of V is also root 2. Right? So basically we are squaring each element and then putting it under, adding up those squares and then putting it under square root. So norm of V will also be माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर प्लस जीरो स्क्वायर प्लस माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर. सो दिस विल गिव यू रूट टू. ओके सो फाइनली यू विल गेट कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल टू माइनस टू बाय रूट टू इंटू रूट टू विच इज बेसिकली नथिंग बट माइनस वन. ओके सो इफ सो सिंस कॉस थीटा इज माइनस वन, थीटा इज नथिंग बट पाई, राइट? वी नो दिस फ्रॉम द फॉर्मुलास. ओके सो दिस इज वन वे ऑफ गेटिंग द एंगल ऑफ रोटेशन. ऑल राइट सो वी हैव गॉट टू थिंग्स फ्रॉम हियर. सो व्हेन यू आर गिवन अ रोटेशन मैट्रिक्स, फर्स्ट इफ यू आर गिवन अ ऑर्थोगोनल मैट्रिक्स, यू हैव टू फाइंड वेदर इट्स अ रोटेशन मैट्रिक्स और अ रिफ्लेक्शन मैट्रिक्स. इफ इट इज अ रोटेशन मैट्रिक्स देन द थिंग्स यू नीड टू फाइंड आर the axis of rotation and then the angle of rotation. Okay. Now another way to confirm that theta is indeed pi would be, how will you get pi, right? Or if g gives you rotation by angle pi, then g square should give you rotation by angle 2 pi, right? And if cos theta, and so cos of 2 pi, right, is basically 1, right? So essentially what you should get is that, if you do the rotation twice, you should get an identity matrix. Okay, so let's see if this is correct. So we have g into g, which is 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 0. So this, let's see what it gives us. So this gives us 1. Right, I hope by now you all know how to do matrix multiplication. So basically we are multiplying row with individual columns. Okay, with first one this, it gives you the first element. Then if you multiply this with the second column, it will give you the second element and so on. So this is 0 and this is also 0. Then you have 0, 1, 0. Then you have, do the matrix multiplication, get 0 here, 0 here and 1 here. Okay, so this is nothing but identity matrix of order 3 cross 3. So if g square gives you I, it means that 2 times theta gives you 2 pi, which means theta is nothing but. So this is how you verify it. Alright. Okay. So this is an example for a rotation matrix. Now let's do another example and see what it is. So the second example will be g is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1 and 0, minus 1, 0. So first thing, so I've already told you that this is an orthogonal matrix. Okay, so I've already told you that you don't need to verify it. But if I have not told you that, then the way to verify it would be to see if M inverse is equal to M transpose. Alright, so but we don't know whether this corresponds to rotation or reflection. So let's find out what is determinant of G. So determinant of G is 1 into 0 minus of 1. So this is basically minus 1. So if determinant of G is, since determinant of G is minus 1, this is a reflection matrix. So the operation is a reflection transformation. So what we need to find is the mappings of this reflection matrix. So by mapping we mean that if it is a reflection, if the operation is to reflect a vector, then we need to find what is the plane of reflection. Okay, so that is what the main point is over here. So how do we find the plane of reflection? So first of all, we know that if a vector is getting reflected, by G, then what happens to the vector, right? So if it's getting reflected, so all the signs will change. So the vector signs are going to change. So basically, if you perform G into R, you will get minus R. So this is the reflection operation. Okay, so sorry, this G is not a vector, but R is a vector. Alright, gives you minus R. Okay, so let's do this. So we need to find what the X, Y, Z is. So let R be Xi plus Yj plus Zk. Okay, so this is our vector. Alright, so let's operate. Okay, so what is G? G is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0 into R. So X, Y, Z gives you minus R. So minus X, minus Y, minus Z. Okay, so this is our system of equations. So let's try to solve this equation. So we have X is equal to minus X. Okay, then we have nothing for Y, but we have minus Z is equal to minus Y. Then we have minus Y is equal to minus Z. So again, X is equal to minus X cannot happen. So only possibility here is X is 0. Okay. And since Z and Y, so these two equations means that Z is equal to Y. So our vector R, right, which is getting reflected, this can be, so assume the lowest number possible for Z equal to Y. So let's assume that 1 is the number. So we have 0, 1, 1. So this is our vector. So this vector is vector that is getting reflected. If this is the vector getting reflected, it means that this vector is perpendicular to the plane of reflection. So if this is perpendicular to the plane of reflection, right, let's assume that there is another vector V. Okay, so let me go to the next page. Okay, so R is a vector that is perpendicular. So R is a vector perpendicular to the plane of reflection. Okay, now let us assume that there is a vector V in the plane of reflection, right? So there is a vector V in the plane of reflection. Okay, so if vector V is in the plane of reflection and R is a vector perpendicular to the plane of reflection, we know that R is perpendicular to V. And so because these two are perpendicular, we'll get that the dot product of these two will give us 0. So again, let's assume a general form for V. General form for V would be Xi plus Yj plus zk. Alright, so this is the general form for v. And if r dot v is 0, it means that, so what is r? We have found out r earlier, right? So r is 0, 1, 1. So this is our r. Okay. So what you will get is y plus z is equal to 0. So the vector v will satisfy the relation z is equal to minus y. Okay. So we can write v to be essentially, right, we can just stop here. Okay, we don't need these things. So all we wanted was what is the plane of reflection, right? So this equation now represents the plane of reflection. Okay. Alright. So this is an equation that represents the plane of reflection. So for G, we have plane of reflection y plus z is equal to 0. Okay. So this is our plane of reflection. So I will stop here and I'll give you two problems so you can work it out yourself. Alright. So let's see. So the homework problems are, find whether the following matrices, following transformation matrices, are rotation or reflection matrices. If it is a rotation matrix, find the axis of rotation and the angle with which a vector is rotated. Okay. If it is a reflection matrix, find the plane of reflection. Okay, so these are the problems. 1, G is equal to 0, 0, minus 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 2, g is equal to 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1. Okay? So these are your problems for homework. All right.